Hi everyone, welcome to this Twinmotion 2021 tutorial. Today we'll be looking at the access to the Quixel Megascan library that has been just added to Twinmotion. Now you can access to around 8,400 Quixel Megascans directly available inside Twinmotion. To find those assets, I will simply come in the left panel over here and open the library. And here you have a new folder, Quixel Megascan. You can find two different types of assets, either the 3D assets, the objects that are in 3D, and the surfaces, which are the material. This is just the first version of the link with the Megascan library. And in the future, we will support more types of objects, like the vegetation or the decals. Let's start now with the 3D asset. And what I want to use in this project might be found in the streets bollard. Here, the first object that appears right away when I click on the folder is the object that are already downloaded and stored on my drive. But all other assets that are present on the Megascan library are just on the cloud, and you just download the object that you want to use for your project. For example, here, if I want to use this object, I will need to download it. And as you can see, at the top right corner of the thumbnail, there is a small download icon. But right now, it's grayed out. It's because I'm not signed in. To sign in, I will simply click on the burger menu and click on the sign in to Epic Games. The first time you will be redirected to a web page, and the second time it will be automatically done directly inside Twinmotion. To update my library, I will just need to come back out and come back in. And now I have the asset, I have the download icon that is not grayed out anymore. For this specific project, what I want to use is maybe some bollard to place on the side of my sidewall cover here. And so let's straight in download one of those assets. So I will come to my metal bollard over here and just click on the download button to download this specific asset. As you can see, it's downloading pretty fast. Now the asset is locally on my machine, but it just imported, basically, it just downloaded the FBX and the texture. And the first time you will drag and drop this asset inside the viewport, it will convert the FBX and the texture into some Twinmotion native asset. This processing is happening only the first time you are using this asset. So now if I'm drag and dropping this asset a second time, as you can see, I don't have this processing anymore. After some bollard, maybe we can add some more details to my sidewalk. So I will come out of that and I will enter maybe the curb. As you can see here, I already downloaded a couple of objects. Let's drag and drop them inside my scene. It's just to add a bit more details to my sidewalk. So we just move that out of the way, a bit inner like that. Move. You also, and here what I will do is maybe use 3 meter as well. As you can see here, the modular curve 3M was not already used in any of my projects. So I have this processing data to convert my FBX inside a Twinmotion native asset. So it's not the same one as this one. I will prefer to stick with the first one. So let me just come back to my first one. And what I will do here is just duplicate the asset. Let's say that I want to duplicate it 3 times with a spacing of 2 meters. Something along those lines will work nicely. Next, what I can do maybe is try changing some materials. So I will come out of the 3D asset folder and I will now enter the surfaces. Let's start maybe with some, not concrete, what we have here, brick, asphalt, asphalt. Let's start with some fine asphalt. Same process with the material. If you want to use a material on your project, I will just click on the download button. Let me just try to find one material that looks nice. As you can see, there is a ton of asset available on the Megascan library. And even if you think you reach the bottom of the folder, asset will still pop out. As you can see here, my bar here is keep resizing as soon as I reach the bottom of the folder. So let's come back up here and maybe let's download the smooth one over here. Same process when you will drag and drop this material on a geometry inside your project. There will be a small processing time. And it again, it's happening just the first time you are using this specific material. Those other material that are on the top was already processed, and I can just drag and drop them inside my scene. And here you can see a bit the quality of the asset that you can find through this link with the Megascan platform. You can find tons and tons of assets. If I come back, for example, to the GUI asset, you can find everything to create some kind of modular building. Like here we have, let me, for example, come to the beam. The beam, you will find plenty of concrete and wood beam. You can find everything to create a modular roof. You have different kind of doors for your buildings. Outside of the 3D, we have the food, industrial. There is tons of possibility with this new link to the Megascan platform. And it's completely free, so just give it a try. Thank you everyone for attending this quick tutorial. Hope you like it and see you for the next one. Bye everyone.